All right, beautiful. This morning, I'm going to be sharing with us a training on titled Effective Planning Strategies to Becoming an Achiever. Effective Planning Strategy to Becoming an Achiever. Please confirm again, go to the chat space and confirm if you can hear me and you can see my screen and that the audio is fine before we run. All right, massive. Effective planning strategy to becoming an achiever. That's going to be the topic of discourse this morning. First of all, let me start by emphasizing on the importance of planning. Planning is critical to effective time management strategy. Planning is the single most important life skill that unfortunately most people never learn how to do properly. Planning is one of the most important life skills that unfortunately most people never learn how to do properly. Planning can be used in every single area of your life. Talking about your financial life, physical planning, development, relationship, or even spiritual, planning is very, very critical, very, very important. Very, very critical and important. Please confirm that the audio is okay and that the visual is also okay, because the network is terrible this morning. I need you to always give me feedback so that I will know, because I need everybody to be carried along this morning. All right, very okay, beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. So like I said, planning is critical to effective time management strategies. It is the single most important life skill that unfortunately most people never learn how to do properly. Planning can be used in every single area of your life, including your financial life, your physical life, your personal development, relationship, or even spiritual. Ladies and gentlemen, a book by Brain Tracy titled Goals reported that fewer than 3% of people have clear written goals and a plan for getting there. Fewer than 3%, less than 3% of people have clear written goals and also have a plan for getting there. No wonder very few persons are achievers. No wonder we have very, very few persons who are achieving their goals and winning every day, while the rest are spectators, because less than 3% of people have their goals clearly written down, and also they have plans on how to achieve their goals. And ladies and gentlemen, anytime you plan in life, it puts you ahead of life. Planning puts you ahead of the pack. Most people never plan. As the saying goes, they said, failure to plan is already planning to fail. One of the reasons why people do not achieve any goal is because they never have any goal set in view for them to achieve at all. Not because they lack what it takes to achieve the goals, not because they cannot become achievers, but guess what? Because they have not defined the goals, they have not even set it in view for them to pursue, to chase, and achieve. That is why they said not to set a goal is not to score any goal. No goal post, no goal. If you have not set any goal anywhere, you can't achieve any goal. Ladies and gentlemen, this morning I'll share with us 3 P's for planning or goal setting. 3 P's for planning or goal setting. The first one is positive. That is, your goal has to be a positive one. For example, you're telling yourself that you're going to build a team that is not lazy. You're telling yourself that you're going to build the largest team in C21FG, where an average individual in your team is earning a minimum of 500K monthly. That is a positive goal. Your goal has to be positive. The next one is personal, I. They must reflect your own dreams and values, not those of your friends, families, or media. There are a lot of people who live their life based on other people's opinion. Ladies and gentlemen, you will agree with me that you cannot pay bills with other people's opinion. You cannot go to the shop, right? You cannot go to the mall and shop with other people's opinion. What they think about you, what they think you should do, what they want you to do. So your goals must reflect your dreams, your values, not those of your friends, your families, or media. The most dangerous one is family and media, because most times, sometimes in life, families can always want to impose on you what they want you to do, which may not tally or rhyme with your dreams and values. A lot of people live their life based on what they see in the social media. They want to live their life based on the standard they see in the social media, which does not reflect their own dream and values. As a result of that, you see a lot of people living a life of the white elephant, a life that does not exist. And also the third P is possible. The third P is possible. Be sure to consider what is possible within your control. What is possible within your control? What is achievable? What is realistic? Do not set goals that are not realistic. You set things that are possible within your control. Even though we said set a goal that stretches you, but it should be something that is also possible, that is achievable, and within your control. This morning, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to share with us goals and targets that exist on this platform. A lot of people are not aware, hence they are not chasing any goal. Hence, they are not achievers. Hence, they are not chasing any target. I'm going to be sharing with us this morning the goals and the targets that exist here. And I'm going to be sharing with us tips on how you can hit these goals, tips on how you can become an achiever, tips on how you can hit your targets. Ladies and gentlemen, if you can see my screen very well, you will see that the status and achievement, the goals or targets available on this platform, carefully outlined. I have about 14 of them. It is not limited to this 14, but I have 14 of them, which you should set, have it clearly written down, and you are already planning on how to hit these goals. For everybody who joins this platform, the first thing you want to achieve that puts you in a position for a better earning is to have a maximum profit centers, is to have a maximum account. And in this category, we have two types of those in this category of achievers. We have those, we call them the max club member, those with the maximum mentality. And we also have the pro max members, those with the pro max mentality. The maximum club members are those who have 15 profit centers or 23 profit centers. It means that they join from the ED 2.0 plan. They didn't join in the ED 3.0 plan. They started their business before the ED 3.0 plan. Ladies and gentlemen, these persons have activated a minimum of 15 profit centers or 23 profit center. Now the Pro Max Club member are also those who have 31 accounts who joined in the ED 3.0 plan, and they have 31 profit centers. Pro Max Club members are those who have combined both. They started from the ED 2.0, they have either 15 or 23, and they also went ahead to activate their mega account by adding the 31 account. They are referred to as the Pro Max Club member. If you're here connected here this morning, one of your goals and targets, if you didn't start with the maximum profit center, is how you can hit your maximum profit center level so that you can position yourself for a better earning, so that you can raise income faster on this platform. Ladies and gentlemen, the second category are, confirm you can hear me, someone is saying no audio. Confirm you can hear me, please. Please go to the chat space and confirm you can hear me. All right, then check your audio, check your audio, check your audio. So the second one is this category or the status of becoming a connector, becoming a connector, a connector. What does it take? What is the requirement for becoming a connector? Now you need to look at all these things, screenshot them, screen grab them, and keep them intact so that you know the status and you know what is required. And then you are asking questions on how. You're asking questions on how. How do I achieve this status? The connector status requires that you generate a minimum of 36 codes in 30 days. A minimum of 36 codes in 30 days. Ladies and gentlemen, the next category or status of achievement is for becoming a senior connector. Becoming a senior connector. Who is a senior connector? A senior connector is someone who became a connector and is able to also raise two other connectors. That is a senior connector. You are a connector and you are able to raise two other connectors within a period of 30 days. It makes you a senior connector. The next category is silver executive. How do you become a silver executive on this platform? It means you have started using the product monthly. And as you use the product, you accumulate the commissional points. And once you have accumulated the commissional points up to 10 points, you become a silver executive. When you accumulate up to 100 points, you become a gold executive. A gold executive, and you will be celebrated. These positions, all these positions comes with income potentials. All these tattoos have been carefully designed by the mastermind and will help you achieve. As you achieve these tattoos, you also achieve the income potentials that comes with these tattoos. The sixth one is the active status. Active status, active status. How do you define the active status? What are the requirements to stay active, becoming active and staying active on this platform? It means that you personally sponsored minimum of two persons in a month. Every month you sponsor a minimum of two, you stay active. It also comes with a crazy income potential by staying active and getting your teammates to stay active. In a period of a month, 30 days, you're able to sponsor at least just two yourself, personally sponsored code. The next category, which is the seventh one, is the Amazon category. Amazon, a female who have earned 500K in a month, 500,000 in a single month, you become an Amazon, you're an Amazon. Females who earn 500K in three consecutive months without breaking are Amazon ambassadors. The next one is the Power 500 Club for males who makes a minimum of 500K in three consecutive months. The Power 500 Club. Ladies and gentlemen, we also have the monthly millionaire status. These are people who makes a minimum of $1 million in 30 days, in a month. You will be recognized and celebrated as a monthly millionaire for achieving the millionaire cycle status. So when you see people being celebrated at the cell meeting, Super Money cell meeting, it means that they've been able to meet up this requirement and that is why they are celebrated. We also have the soaring connectors status. The soaring connector status. The soaring connector status means that you are a connector and you have been able to work with five of your teammates on different lineage personally sponsored by you to also become a connector. For an elite connector, you and nine others have become connectors. You become an elite connector. Ladies and gentlemen, we also have the 2-comma club. People who have earned 1 million naira in 3 consecutive months. It means the first month you made a minimum of 1 million naira, second month a minimum of 1 million naira, third month a minimum of 1 million naira. You become a 2-comma club member. You become a 2-comma club member. Ladies and gentlemen, the next one is the millionaire mentor. Millionaire mentor status. A millionaire mentor status are those persons who have not just become a 2-comma club member, they have also mentored their personally sponsored teammates who also became a 2-comma club member. Underline the word, personally sponsored teammates. So the people you recruit and bring them on board, it is expected that you stay with them, work with them, help them to achieve any of these status, and you will be celebrated also. Ladies and gentlemen, the greatest of all is becoming a millionaire mentor. And the reason is very simple. You are celebrated not for because you are earning, but you are celebrated by also helping others to earn. In C21FG, we celebrate trainers, mentors more than earners. A millionaire mentor is not just someone who has succeeded in becoming a 2-comma club member, but you have also helped someone to become a 2-comma club member. So ladies and gentlemen, if these goals and targets, as I've explained, is clear this morning, please go to the chat and space and type understood. Go to the chat space and type understood. This outline status or achievement, goals and targets available on this platform, you need to know. Because when you know, you can pursue, you can chase, you can set them and hit them. If it is clear for so many persons, they are just getting to know the targets, the goals and targets for the first time. For so many persons, they are getting to see them being celebrated at the Super Money Cell meetings, but they don't really even know what are the requirements it takes to hit or achieve them. This morning, it has been outlined to you. And the implication is that after this training this morning, we're going to be having a lot of achievers in different categories outlined this morning. We're going to be celebrating a lot of people who are going to be hitting these goals and targets. The requirements are there, clearly spelled out. So ladies and gentlemen, after setting out the goals and targets, after clearly spelling out the goals and targets this morning, I'm going to be sharing with us 11 planning tips to hitting these goals. Who is ready? Who is ready? Who is ready? After sharing with you the goals and targets that are available on this platform that you need to pursue and hit, I'm going to be sharing with you this morning 11 planning tips to hitting and achieving them. So the question now is, who is ready? Who is ready? Who is ready? Who is ready? Who is ready for these tips? Who is ready for these tips? All right, a lot of persons are ready. A lot of persons are ready this morning. All right, let's run quickly so that we can manage our time effectively. I'm going to exceed 9 a.m. this morning so that we can effectively do what we have this morning. That is why it is a power combined cell meeting. So ladies and gentlemen, the first step is this. The first step or tip is this. Understand your organization's strategic mission and define your personal goal. Understand your organization's strategic mission and define your personal goal. We have a vision and a mission here. We also have organizational goals here, which you can also look at and draw your personal goals. Like I have outlined, you can look at it and decide, where do I start from? And then get to the maximum. Where do I start from? You can't understand everything at the same time. You pick one after another, understand it, crush it, you move to the next level. Understand it, crush it, you move to the next level. First of all, you pick the first one. Your goal is, let me hit the maximum club members. Let me become a pro max, or let me become a max club member. The next one, you pick the categories of a connector, becoming a connector. You hit becoming a connector because you must first of all become a connector before you can become a senior connector. Understand these goals, understand the mission, understand the vision here so that you can align yourself with the vision and the power of the vision will work for you. So the question is, these are the questions you ask. What exactly do you want to accomplish from the bigger pie? What exactly do you want to accomplish from the bigger pie? Secondly, what achievement will worth your very best effort? What achievement will worth your very best efforts? Thirdly, what will you attempt if you knew it was impossible for you to fail? What will you attempt to achieve if you knew it was impossible to fail? Fourthly, what will you go for if you knew this was your very last chance? If you knew that this was your very last chance, what will you go for? Fifthly, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like us to understand and make sure that your vision is clear. Make sure that your vision is clear and powerful. One that you will follow despite whatever setbacks and failure that might arise along the way. Make sure it is clear. If your visions and your purpose are not clear, it becomes easy for you to throw in the towel. It becomes easy for you to quit. It becomes easy for you to become a complainer rather than a solution finder. Make sure your vision is clear. Make sure your vision is powerful. Make sure they are so strong that they can make you go ahead despite failure, setback, and challenges. Ladies and gentlemen, that is the first tip. You must understand the organizational strategic mission and define your personal goal. Number two, step two, ask yourself this question, where are you right now? Identify where you are currently. For you to be able to make progress, you must identify where you are currently in this business. Identify how many profit centers you have. Identify what is your income status. Identify your leadership status on this platform. Carefully examine where you are right now in terms of your goals. Find out where you are. It will help you to move to the next level. A lot of people do not even know their status or where they are currently. Find out. Some people are going through the SMO checklist training. If you ask them, what week are you? They are not even aware and they are going through the training. Always know where you are per time. It helps you to move to the next level. Are you in the incubator? Are you in the week two, which is the committed leaders group? Are you in the master class one or are you in the master class two? Find out where you are. If you're building already, you're using your 5-5-5 worksheet, find out the stage where you are. It helps you to make progress. You will also find out whether you have just been getting by or you do the training to reach the next level. Have you just been getting by or do you train to reach the next level? Do you get trained to reach the next level or you've just been getting by or you've just been having a lucky jump? Remember, when you have a lucky jump to the top, you will definitely come back to the ground level. It's sure. The next question is, are you willing to do the things you may not want to do in order to reach your goals? Are you willing to do the things you may not want to do in order to reach your goals? Ladies and gentlemen, trust me this morning. There are a lot of things, bulk of things that ordinarily you will not want to do, but you must do them to get to where you are going to. Nobody wants to stay awake at night. Nobody wants to read that book. Nobody wants to prospect. Nobody wants to connect. But guess what? You have to do these things for you to get or reach your goals. What differentiates the successful ones from the unsuccessful is that the successful ones feel like not doing it and still go ahead and do it. That is why they are successful. The third tip this morning, ladies and gentlemen, is be honest about what you need to do. Be honest about what you need to do. In order to get to where you want to go to, you have to know how to get there. If I want to go to Lagos from Abuja, I need to find out how to get to Lagos from Abuja. And I must be honest about it. You must figure out what you need to do in order to get to where you need to go to be honest about what you need to do. Ladies and gentlemen, the fourth step is this. Formulate a daily improvement plan. Formulate a daily improvement plan. This is the most important step of the goal setting process. Ladies and gentlemen, we have this on this platform. That is why we have our DMO, daily method of operation. What you need to do every day to hit your goals. What you need to do every day to get to where you want to get to. It is the most important step in goal setting processes. Formulate a daily plan. If you're connected here this morning and you don't have a daily plan, you just come out and walk anyhow, anywhere, belly face, that is where you go. Guess what? You can't hit your goal. You can't get to your destination. Ask yourself this question. What can I do on a daily basis to work towards reaching my goals? This has to be clear. What can I do on a daily basis to work towards reaching my goals? Until you can ask yourself this question and find an answer, you're not making progress. You can never hit your goals. That is why we have our daily KPI showing you. Daily KPI is like a speedometer, reading the number of kilometers left for you or has been covered to reach your goals. That is why if you're not doing your daily KPI, I pity you. I know you're not going anywhere. Some leaders connected here still struggle to do their daily KPI. You must not only report your KPI when you have a result. Report it even if it is zero, so that you are aware that it is zero. It does something to your brain. It does something to your mind. It tells your mind that there's fire on the mountain, that there is an emergency. I need to do something. Not even reporting it at all, you are not seeing it. Because your mind tried to bury the fact that you have zero. But by bringing it out and making it open that you have zero, even though it is embarrassing, makes you to wake up, makes you to sit up, and you begin to chase your goal properly. You begin to follow your daily expected activities. Ladies and gentlemen, the fifth one is this. Make and work on short-term goals. Ladies and gentlemen, we always have long-term goals and we have short-term goals. For somebody connected here this morning, your goal might be to becoming a millionaire mentor on this platform. But guess what? You can't just hit it like that. You must make short-term goals. Like first of all, I must have a maximum profit center. Without having a maximum profit center, you can't become a millionaire mentor. I must first of all become a connector. Without becoming a connector, you can't become a millionaire mentor. Millionaire mentor is the long-term goal, but becoming a connector is a short-term goal. Make and work on your short-term goals. The goals that you set in step one may take a long time to reach, perhaps months or even years. But guess what, ladies and gentlemen? Short-term goals keep you motivated throughout this time. It might take you 1 year to become a millionaire mentor, but because you have short-term goals that you are achieving on a monthly basis, it keeps you motivated and you go through the process until you hit your long-term goal. Achieving these goals will give you feedback on your progress toward your ultimate goals. How you are crushing your short-term goals will give you a feedback to know whether you're progressing towards your ultimate goal or not. Ladies and gentlemen, they should be process-oriented and reflect the achieving, and reflect that you are achieving your goals is an ongoing process. That is why we said success is a journey and not a destination. Those small achievements, the short-term goals are the things that keeps you going. These are part of the process that takes you to your ultimate goal, your overall goal. Ladies and gentlemen, the sixth step is this. You must commit and declare your goals or plan. You must commit and also declare your goals or plan. Ladies and gentlemen, it is easy to say you are going to do it. It is easy to say something. Actually doing it is another story. That's why they said it is easier said than done. I want to become a connector this month is easier said than done. So after saying this is what you want, commit to it and declare it, tell the whole world, let everyone know and stay focused on it. Once you have announced your goal, it helps you to stay on it. At any time, if you're going to be distracted, the people around who you have announced to that this is what you're going to achieve will draw you back. They will always remind you that, remember you told us that you're going to become a monthly millionaire in this business you're doing. It's like you're doing something else now. It's like you're derailed. It's like you're distracted. You must declare your goals to your mentor, to your teammate. Everybody must know and stay focused. Tip number 7, continually monitor your progress. Continually monitor your progress. Don't start a journey and wait until you get to your destination before you assess what you are doing. Assess what you are doing. Track what you are doing. Monitor your progress every single day. Am I getting closer to my dreams? Am I getting closer to my vision? Am I getting closer to my goals? Ladies and gentlemen, every day you must ask yourself if you are getting closer to your goals and your dreams. Is your goal plan actually working, or does it need adjustment? There are a lot of us, the strategy we are running with is actually not working. But because we are not monitoring, because we are not tracking it, we are not even aware whether it is working or not. That is one of the things the KPI helps you do. It helps you know whether you should change the strategy. Remember, you don't change the goal. You can change the strategy, or you're not permitted to change the goal or your targets. Is your goal plan actually working, or does it need adjustment? Is your strategy actually working, or does it need adjustment? If your answer is, I am not sure, hello, then you are not really making progress. If you are thinking whether your strategy is effective or not, you're not sure, then the truth is you're not making progress at all. Write down what your small success and lesson learned along the way, or make a checklist. Make a checklist that charts your progress. That is what the KPI does for you. If you are doing your weekly KPI, at the end of the day, you're able to compare your week one, your week two, your week three, week four. You will know whether you're making progress or not. Ladies and gentlemen, continually monitor your progress. That is why you must not joke with your KPI. If you're connected here this morning and you have not started doing your KPI, is not only for full-timers. Part-timers also have their KPI that guides them and help them know whether they are doing the activities that causes growth. If you're not doing your KPI, if you're not running with your KPI, ladies and gentlemen, I can assure you that you are not going to become an achiever. You can't become an achiever because you will definitely miss your way. But the KPI will keep you on track. Ladies and gentlemen, the tip number 8, know yourself. Know yourself. A lot of people do not know themselves. Know yourself. Do a self-SWOT analysis. Do a self-SWOT analysis to know yourself. When you know yourself, it helps you to win faster. When you know yourself, it helps you to achieve what you want to achieve even more faster. Do a self-SWOT analysis. Ladies and gentlemen, SWOT analysis is a framework for analyzing your strengths. We all have strengths. For analyzing your weaknesses, we all have our weaknesses also, as well as the opportunities available and also the threats that you face. That is what the SWOT analysis means. It means you analyzing your strengths, taking note of your strengths, being aware of your strengths so that you can improve more on your strengths. Being aware of your weaknesses and finding a way to address it, and also the opportunities and threats that are available in your environment. Ladies and gentlemen, know yourself. Do a SWOT analysis. If you do a SWOT analysis, if you know yourself, it helps you to focus on your strengths. It helps you to minimize your weaknesses. It helps you to take the greatest possible advantage of the opportunity available to you. Know yourself if you must become an achiever. Know yourself if you must become an achiever. Ladies and gentlemen, the ninth one this morning, as I begin to round up, is become emotionally intelligent. Be emotionally intelligent. Be emotionally intelligent. Ladies and gentlemen, emotional intelligence is defined as the ability to perceive, use, understand, and manage, handle emotions. The ability to perceive, use, understand, manage, and handle emotions in positive ways. And this will help you to relieve stress. This will help you to communicate effectively. This will help you to empathize with others. And this will also help you overcome challenges and diffuse conflicts. You must be emotionally intelligent. Remember, if you're not emotionally intelligent, things that happen around you will determine where you end. And like Jim Rohn always said, it is not what happens around us, it is what happens inside of us. You must be emotionally strong. You must be emotionally intelligent for you to be able to take charge of your inner environment. It is not about what happens around you. Guess what? In our business, if you're not emotionally intelligent, you will quit. You will fail. Because you will always allow what happens around you to define your actions. Because you've got a lot of no's, because you are rejected, you're already thinking whether you should quit or not. But if you're emotionally intelligent, you will be able to react to these things in a positive way. That is why Jim Rohn said, it is not the blowing of the wind that determines the destination of the boats, but the set of the sail. It is not what happens around you that determines where you end, but what happens inside of you. The same thing that took you down is the same thing that took another person up. Emotional intelligence, how we react to things in our environment. And ladies and gentlemen, what are the characteristics of emotional intelligence? Self-awareness, self-regulation. We also have motivation, empathy, and then social skills. These are the characteristics of emotional intelligence. Time will fail me to break each of these one for us because I'm already running out of time. The 10th tip this morning is be effective at managing your energy. A lot of people do not manage their energy. That is why they are not winning. They have what we call the scattered bomb. Their energy is all over everywhere. Hence, they are achieving nothing. They are jack of all trades and master of none. They are prospecting and grinding in all the states. Any state you go, they are grinding there. No wonder they are not an achiever. All you need to do is to manage your energy. Figure out where you need to win per time and deploy your energy and win there before you move to the next place. I had a meeting yesterday with the Alpha team leads and I told them this, that you must figure out where you need to win. Find out where you need to grind. Not that they said, there's a big event in Kefi, you are running there. There's a big event in Makurdi, you are also speeding there. There's a big event in Abuja. You want to raise leaders all the states, whereas you have not raised anyone. Like I told people, being the owner of a completed building is more better than being the owner of 10 uncompleted buildings. I have 10 uncompleted buildings. It doesn't give you money. Like having a completed building that is usable. So be effective at managing your energy. Last week, you are booking Kaduna event. This week, you are booking this one. You have abandoned Kaduna, you are booking the next one. Next week, you are abandoned this week, you are booking the next one. You can't succeed. That is scattered bomb. Your energy is being dispersed everywhere. As a result, you achieve nothing. I also told the team lead yesterday, I said, identify your teammates who are ready to run. Few of them. That is why the concept of 5-5-5 worksheet came in. Identify the five and stay with them so that your energy can be sufficient for them. You cannot be working with multitude of persons. If you're working closely with more than five, it means you're working with too many persons at your level. Be effective at managing your energy. With more time and little energy, you achieve less. You have much time, little energy, you achieve less. And with more energy and little time, you can achieve more. You see, some people come to the office from morning till night. They give little energy to what they do, and they achieve very, very less. Somebody will come to the office. He said he's a full-timer. At the end of the day, he's closing. How many persons have you booked? He said 10. He said 15. No, now. You have a lot of time, but you didn't give your energy to achieve more. And you see, some people came to the office. They came by 12 noon, and before 2 p.m., they have booked 20. More energy, little time. They're achieving more. Ladies and gentlemen, your energy level rises with your mental, your physical, your emotional, and spiritual lives. Your energy level rises with your mental, your physical, emotional, and spiritual. So, ladies and gentlemen, you must pay attention to this level, your mental, your physical, your emotional, and your spiritual part of your life. And finally this morning, I'm about to round up. So sorry for taking your time. Finally, I'm about to round up. The tip number 11 is plan on paper. Hello? Plan on what? On paper. Any goal not written down cannot be actualized. Any goals not written down, not captured, can never be achieved. Even the scripture made it clear that it is fundamental for you to write down the vision. Say, make it plain upon tablet. Write down the vision, make it clear, so that as you read it that day, you are running with it. Never start your day without writing what you want to do that day. Start and end your day with a to-do list. What do I need to do today to become a connector at the end of the month? My goal, my target this month is to become a connector. So what do I need to do today? It has to be clearly written down. How many persons must see my opportunities today for me to be able to be sure that I am moving towards my goal? Start and end your day with a to-do list. Anytime you don't have written goals, you easily fall into another man's plan. You fall into another man's agenda. But you have your written goals down, you will stick with them and achieve them. Ladies and gentlemen, this is where I am rounding up this morning. Always round up your day with these three daily critical questions. These are three daily critical questions you must ask yourself every single day. The first one is, what were the things I did well today? Before you go to bed, ask yourself, what were the things I did well today? Ladies and gentlemen, identify them and give yourself credit accordingly. You must find out, these are your strengths. What have I done today? Very well. Identify them and give yourself credit accordingly. The next question you must ask yourself every day is, what should I have done better today? What have I done that I could have done better? Ladies and gentlemen, research and learn the skills needed for you to do it better. That is how you get better. No wonder Eric Worre said, progress is perfection. Progress is perfection. You're asking yourself this question. This thing that I have done, is there a better way I would have done it much more better and get more results? If the answer is yes, research, find out the skills and learn them. And the last question you must always ask yourself before you sleep every day is, what are my topmost priority for tomorrow? What are my topmost priorities for the next day? These three questions must be answered before you go to bed. List them out. Think of the smartest and most cost-effective way of implementing them, and you will discover that you are achieving them accordingly. Ladies and gentlemen, congratulations to every one of us. This is where we are going to be ending our training this morning. Strategies to effective planning for becoming an achiever. To becoming an achiever on this platform. Congratulations to every one of us who connected this morning. I want to believe that you got